Hey guys, it's Peter here. I just finished my first year of medicine at Deakin University. Unfortunately, this was during lockdown time, so I only had 2 in-person classes a week. I'm hoping that this video can give you a bit more insight into what a day in the life of a med student is like, my dynamic with my classmates, as well as a bit of advice and background on med school. Hope you enjoy the vlog.
Give us a cheeky review of Deakin Med so far.
It's better than in uni, I'll tell you that.
You'll always be my day one. Day zero when I was no one. I'm nothing but myself. You are no one else. Thankful you're my day one. Thankful you're my.
I got lucky finding you. I won't make the day that I came across you. Cause when you're with me, I don't feel blue. Not a day goes by that I would not redo.
Good morning, finished packing up. Now I'm gonna drive down to med school. I'm gonna go pick up my friend because his partner had to take the car. He has nowhere to get to uni other than take a bus. And Peter, you to the rescue.
A few moments later.
What is this?
Oh, hey, Toby.
Hello.
So you've been left stranded today, hi?
I have been, yes. And not all med students are as disorganized as I am.
Oh, no, that's cat.
18, we were undergrads. Stayed out late, never made it to class. Out of restaurant in a taxi cab. You were swimming bullets on the way to my dad's. And you said,
all right, so we're on campus right now. Got Toby with me. We're a bit early, eh? What was your mindset coming into med as like a slightly older student than the cohort?
Yeah, look, I was aware, you know, I was slightly older. I'm 33, and so a lot of my classmates are at least, you know, 10 years younger than I am. And you get little reminders, I guess, because, you know, your classmates are watching different things there. You know, med student cohorts are usually quite welcoming and, you know, fairly empathetic people, you'd imagine. So it hasn't really been an issue. You know, I've never felt alienated.
How long did it take you to find a place in Geelong?
Pretty quickly, actually.
That's good.
I mean, we offered slightly more than they were advertising, like 10 bucks.
Oh, yeah, same. We had $5 extra a week. That's pretty funny.
I know.
We're at the Deakin Library, and look at this studious man. Look at this specimen. He's been wanting to be on the vlog for ages. This is Tariq, T Vlogs.
Hey everyone.
So this is our PBL rooms where we do our case studies in our groups.
The best PBL is PBL 12.
The best PBL is PBL 14 because I'm in it.
PBL 12
is totally. So we're getting some coffee now just before the class starts.
The biggest tip for med school, for a lab, get a coffee. They're 3 hours, get a coffee and you'll survive.
Well, 2 hours if you do it fast, right? Like us.
How's my favorite med student, Pete?
Oh, you know, I'm great. Oh, Tariq's hurt.
So
it's because I got the camera on.
Yes.
Good day. Hello, Joydeep.
How's it going?
How you going? Sarah, oh, you gotta put that coat back on.
You know?
You just finished a workshop. Sarah copied all my answers today for the first time in ever. Normally I copy Sarah's. Even though she's always written her notes, she doesn't actually know what she's talking about.
Like things you want to say to other medical students?
It can seem tough at times, but yeah, just always keep your head up and surround yourself with good people who motivate you.
So meet the crew. This is Georgia, Cameron, How you going? This is Sarah. She's also camera shy.
One of the questions they asked us was, can you work whilst you're studying med? And if so, how many hours?
You can definitely work in med. There's heaps of people who do like 1 or 2 days a week. I'm going to start doing 1 day a week at one of the hospitals, but you med.
What are you doing at the hospital?
A midwife.
I'm a neurotech. You need to like set time for study and set time for work. Everyone's different. And I'm going to do probably 8 hours a week.
And a bunch of the other physios and causes still working. I just choose not to.
How many hours do you choose?
It fluctuates. It's anywhere between 10 to 15 in a week. Coming into med, there's less pressure on you to try to get in. So you tend to like lay back a little bit more and have a better work-life balance in general. With that being said, it is pretty demanding. There's a lot of content. You just need to not pull a Peter and be behind.
Yeah.
See you, Cam. See you, Joy. See you. Sarah.
Sorry.
So where are we heading right now? I'm getting a haircut. Sarah wants grilled, so we're probably gonna go
Mad
get
Max,
grilled.
Mad Max,
my bad. See you there. Just got to Warm Ponds shopping center. Oh my goodness, my hair. I'm gonna go get a haircut. And I've got Sarah with me, cause she wants some Mexican food.
So other people ask, why do you wanna be a doctor? That's basically the first question they ask in all the interviews.
I said more like, you have lifelong learning, so it's a career that like you never stop learning,
yeah.
You never stop growing. You have patients from like the moment of birth until the moment they die.
Yeah,
so you have that like insane continuity of care. Like the scope of practice, so you can do a lot, big procedures like out rural and stuff. I was in Africa and then I saw this woman die from like, you know, postpartum hemorrhage. She had a big bleed after birth.
Yeah.
And then it's just so preventable here because like no one really dies from that in Australia.
Yeah.
So I wanted to do something that can like stop all these deaths.
That's good, you can draw on some of your experiences. I had no experience.
Yeah, I had too many experiences. That was like the one thing I
could
talk about in the interview.
Your midwife and nursing background, yeah. Someone asked, is med more difficult than biomed?
That's your question.
Or does it get easier once you're in? I'd say the content is a bit harder. And there's less pressure the first 2 years before you do clinical placement because you just need to pass everything. Whereas in biomed, you have to keep up like all HD, so that's a lot of pressure on you. And you're constantly thinking about like, oh, can I get into med or not?
Yeah.
I found after getting into med, I'm a lot more like happy about doing assignments or like doing work. So.
Hey, so I just got a haircut at Warm Ponds Shopping Center at Grindstone Barbers. Now I'm gonna go back home because I've got tutoring in about an hour and a half. Tutor for an hour and then come back out to Deakin Warm Ponds because I think a couple of the boys wanna go play basketball at 6. Just got home, gonna go shower, clean up this mess. Gonna study for a bit and got a student a little bit later today.
2 hours later.
It's back on Deakin. A bit of hoops. Good to see the boys. You can see them in the background.
Nope.
What kind of advice would you give someone if they didn't get an offer 1 year and then like that was their first year of trying?
Just think about what lets you down and then you practice on that.
Okay.
So like the interviews let me down 100% and like I spent probably 2 months in just like little online like Zoom meetings with friends, just like every single week going through topics, bouncing ideas off each other and then doing like practice stations with each other.
Just finished a game of basketball. It was pretty fun. So a bunch of med kids usually play on Tuesday. Pretty much done for the day. I think I'm just gonna go home and relax. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. I'm gonna call it a day here. And I will see you guys later.
No matter how much we fight, can't let go of you. Got this hold on you.
Tariq asked, is Tariq the hottest?
Oh, that's me. I thought someone else did it.
Yeah.
count?
How many times we thought that we were done and we came back, so we ain't going nowhere, cause we love right where we